Hello, this is Tony Heller from RealClimateScience.com, setting the record straight about climate and other things. I don't own a television and I almost never watch TV, but I got a flat tire last night and was sitting in the tire store today watching Sunday morning talk shows. I was pretty horrified by the dishonesty and manipulation on display by the host of Face the Nation. She started out not too awful with this segment.
The president has tweeted 13 times in the past 24 hours about Congressman Elijah Cummings. I want to read the first tweet. He said, "Why is so much money sent to the Elijah Cummings district when it's considered the worst run and most dangerous anywhere in the United States? No human being would want to live there. Where's all the money going? How much is stolen? Investigate immediately." What is the objective?
So let's look at the president's tweet. He's accusing Elijah Cummings of corruption. He's saying that Elijah Cummings' district is a terrible place to live, and that no human being would want to live there. He's saying that money is being stolen and that it needs to be investigated. The president is making his point abundantly clear. This is a statement of empathy towards the people who have to live in that district and an attack on the corrupt politicians who are making the mess there. It's a perfectly reasonable thing to say, and long past time that someone said it. I know a lot about that district. I used to live about 10 miles away from there in Columbia, Maryland. I've done several year-long stints working for defense contractors in Maryland. When I lived there, I lived in an apartment where I was the only white person. My neighbors were black or Asian, and most of the black people who lived in the apartment complex had moved there to escape the neighborhood in Baltimore which the president was referring to. They said it was a terrible place to live, and they had moved to Columbia because it was a much better place to raise their children. The crime, the gangs, the drugs, the poverty there was intolerable, and everyone who had a way to get out did. So what the president was saying was absolutely correct. He wants to investigate the mess and make things better for the people who live there. But the agenda of Face the Nation is not to get at the truth, it's to attack President Trump. So look at what the host of Face the Nation did next.
Well, you know, though, that this is a majority black district. And when the president calls it rat infested, he says no human being would live there. Do you understand that that is offensive to the Americans who do live there?
She changed the wording of what President Trump said. She changed it from no human being would want to live there to no human being would live there. The implication of her wording being that the people who live there are not human beings. So by changing the president's words to something he didn't say, she made it sound like he was being racist, when in fact he was being the exact opposite. It was her who made it about race. Then for the next few segments of the show, she had other people on, and the entire discussion was based around something the president didn't say. And that discussion was followed by a segment about Russian interference in U.S. elections. But the attempted interference in the election that's going on here is by Face the Nation. They're flat out lying about what the president said, in a very transparent attempt to interfere with the next election outcome. I was in downtown Baltimore the day before the riots started in 2015. It often is a horrible place. The host of Face the Nation would certainly not want to live in that neighborhood. She wouldn't last a week there. When Democrat Martin O'Malley was mayor of Baltimore, more people were arrested than the entire population of the city. That's a pretty incredible statistic. Think about it. Not only were police cars destroyed, but all the businesses owned by Koreans were summarily destroyed by rioters. There's tremendous racism and hatred against non-black people in that neighborhood. My best friend in Colombia is an immigrant from the Caribbean. She came to the United States with nothing and worked her way through college and graduate school and got a master's degree in education. She wanted to help out the kids in Baltimore, so she took a job in the Baltimore public schools. She tried to teach there for several years, but eventually quit when she was about to have a nervous breakdown. The kids had no interest in learning. Money was being poured into the district and they were getting lots of new equipment. The kids would take their brand new laptops and throw them on the floor. Every day they would call her the N-word and they would tell her to go back to Africa, even though she'd never even been to Africa. They made it clear that they did not want her help. President Trump is absolutely correct. No human being would want to live there. The people who live there because they have no other choice. He was making a strong statement of empathy to people who have to live there and have no option to get out. Baltimore has been under Democratic rule for decades, and the Democrats have allowed it to slide into this total mess. But they don't care. The only thing they care about is that they get the black votes. Later on Face the Nation, they had a guest on who said that President Trump was trying to divide people again like he did in 2016, when in fact it's the Democrats who are trying to do that, just like they did all through the Obama years with race baiting and race riots. President Trump wants to fix the bad neighborhoods in America, and the Democrats want to keep them there, so they promote this false idea that the president is a racist. But the real racists are people like Margaret Brennan, people who don't want the neighborhoods fixed, people who want to divide America, people who want the terrible status quo maintained, and people act offended by the president's accurate description of the neighborhood while knowing that everything the president was saying was absolutely true. President Trump was making a lot of important points in that tweet, and she was doing everything she could to misrepresent them. The last thing Democrats would want would be for poor black neighborhoods to improve, because then people would start voting Republican. The people who live in that neighborhood deserve better, and decades of Democratic rule is what made the mess. We do have a class of people who are working tirelessly to interfere in U.S. elections, and it's largely people like the host of Face the Nation. Visit Toto on the web at realclimatescience.com. He's been pulling back the curtain on junk science, propaganda, and organized crime for a long time.